Replacing your windows will pop, pop, please fix. Right window, over. EBCU time, 11:19. Sunny and warm, 87 degrees in Boston. Good morning. I'm Tony Croke at WBZ News. Here's what we're following in the WBZ News for more severe weather hitting Oklahoma. Oklahoma City area hit by tornadoes once again. Five people reported dead, dozens hurt. Deadly fire in Houston, Texas, killing four firefighters who were buried after a motel and restaurant collapsed on them. The intersection of Mystic Valley Parkway, Medford Street, and Arlington reopening to traffic. That's after a Framingham man is hospitalized after the tanker truck he was driving flipped over yesterday. And Lieutenant Governor Tim Murray says he has mixed emotions as he prepares to leave the job he's held for nearly 6.5 years. Last day in office is tomorrow. Zumba fitness instructor pleaded guilty to using a Kenny Buckman studio as a front for prostitution, going to jail now, bringing to an end a scandal featuring sex videos, adultery, and exhibitionism. Alexis Wright sentenced in Maine yesterday under a plea agreement to 10 months in jail for 20 counts. Wright was accused of conspiring with an insurance business owner to run a prostitution business, which he videotaped clients without their knowledge and kept detailed records over an 18-month period, indicating she made $150,000 while collecting welfare. The state's landmark anti-bullying law could see some changes to stiffen reporting requirements on school districts, create a recognition that certain students are more vulnerable to bullying. State Rep. Alice Peisch talks about proposed changes to the anti-bullying legislation.
One is to provide a reporting mechanism so that there's a way to monitor how much of this activity is occurring in the school. And then the second is to require that the plan identify specific groups of students that are perceived to be targets of bullying.
Well, that's good. Say that the next step to enhance the tough 2010 anti-bullying law. Opponents argue it's another burden on school districts unable to comply with the law because it is unfunded. Memorial service will be held today in Kingston, New Hampshire for Nancy Lanza. She's the mother of the gunman who killed 20 students and 6 teachers at a Connecticut elementary school before turning the gun on himself. Adam Lanza shot his mother to death before his December rampage at Sandy Hook Elementary School in Newtown, Connecticut.
Take a walk around.
Well, Lou Reed's wife says the rock icon is recovering after a life-saving liver transplant. The AP's Marta McDelwick reports.
Family under study has told the Times Tribune that Reed was dying before the operation several weeks ago at Ohio's Cleveland Clinic. She says that the 71-year-old is not back to full strength, but that he's already working and doing Tai Chi. She doubts that he'll ever totally recover, but says he'll certainly be back to doing things in a few months. And in some also praises the Cleveland facility and says that hospitals in New York where they live were dysfunctional. Martha McDowell, London.
A New Hampshire auction house selling medical records and a handwritten letter from Gangster Al Capone detailing the final years of his life and declining health. Capone's letter to his doctor, postmarked August 25th, 1941, 2 years after his prison sentence for tax evasion, was up.
Just roads and weather.
Next weather in just 10 minutes.
Are now together. Trouble west of town on ACT and Chile every 10 minutes.
The roads are upset.
At 3, 14, 23, 33, 42, and 53 past the hour.
10 minutes
of News Watch. Weather Watch. Watch. Never stop. WBZ. News Radio 1030.
News Time 11:23, traffic and weather together. Studio dealers of London on their time traffic on the freeze. Brought to you by findmassmoney.com. Really fine traffic wise, Lee Michaels. All right, that Doug Store Drive heading inbound. Still very heavy and slow moving traffic. Got that right lane shut down inside the Store Tunnel. That is traffic rolling back beyond the BU Bridge. Also, Memorial Drive is shut down both ways between JFK and Western Avenue all day today for the festival in Cambridge. Just followed the detours there. South of town, the expressway sounds still slow at the Dorchester Yacht Club all the way down to Nefonte. Northbound is heavy but moving up to the O'Neill Tunnels. Route 3 heading south, though, watch for delays around Route 18 and Weymouth down to the lane drop at Derby Street in Hingham. Not a bad ride right now getting on and off the Cape. Elsewhere, lower end of 95 south, dealing with a disabled bus pass Mechanic Street in Sharon North for a slowdown there. 24 is okay along with the lower end of 128 north of the city. 495 heading northbound, still a lot of volume through Amesbury heading to 95. Route 3 and 95.
23, though, doing okay in and out of New Hampshire, Route 1, that through the Saga stretch, that's okay. West of town, the Mass Turnpike, that's the speed limit ride both ways. Next report comes your way at 11:33 on WBZ's Traffic on the Freeway.
Claim your share of more than $2 billion in unclaimed property, like forgotten bank accounts, stock certificates, payroll and refund checks, or insurance proceeds. 1 in 10 people have unclaimed property and don't even know it. Call 888-344-MASS or visit FindMassMoney.com.
WBZ News Time, 11:24. Let's check the 4 day and accurate the forecast. Meteorologist Brian Thompson is going to tell us it's another sweltering day today.
It's a sunny, hot and humid this afternoon with a high of 92. Partly cloudy and muggy tonight, low 67. Then a breezy and humid day tomorrow while clouds and some sunshine. A shower and thunderstorm in some spots very late in the day. A slightly better chance to get into tomorrow night. High tomorrow, 84. So not quite as hot tomorrow. And it will be noticeably cooler by Monday with clouds and a few showers and thunderstorms, a high of 72. Sunshine Tuesday, less humid with a high 74. I'm after what meteorologist Brian Thompson, WBZ News Radio, 10:30.
Good beach day, by the way, if you're going to the beach. Next, high tide at 6:33 p.m. It's 55 degrees, the water temperature at Nantasket Beach, if you are headed there. Air temperature, though, much more, 88 degrees at Logan Airport, 86 here at WBZ.
WBZ Box Office.
You're the 11th caller, 617-931-1030. Receive a $30 gift certificate. You can...